Imagine waking up in a place where the sunrise isn't golden, but a deep orange hue, filtered through a thin atmosphere. The air you breathe doesn't come from forests, but from life support systems that hum quietly through the walls of your home. We're no longer on Earth. We're living in a completely new world. By the end of the 21st century, humanity finally took the step that once seemed impossible, establishing permanent colonies on other planets. We're not talking about simple space stations, but entire cities designed to house families, businesses, schools, and even parks, all under transparent domes that protect us from the deadly cold of space. The first destination was the Moon, our closest neighbor, transformed into a staging point for more distant missions. But the true dream was always Mars, and now, with ultra-fast propulsion technology and habitats capable of simulating Earth's gravity and pressure, that dream has shifted from science fiction to reality. But getting there was only the beginning. The real adventure lies in turning hostile worlds into welcoming homes. And that's exactly what we're going to explore next, how to terraform an entire planet so human life can flourish. Transforming Mars or any other planet into a habitable environment is one of the most ambitious challenges humanity has ever faced. Imagine trying to turn a frozen, toxic desert into a place with rivers, forests, and a blue sky. It's like rebuilding Earth from scratch. The first step is warming the planet. To do this, gigantic orbital mirrors reflect sunlight directly onto the surface, raising the global temperature. At the same time, automated factories release specific gases into the atmosphere to create a controlled greenhouse effect. In just a few decades, underground ice begins to melt, forming lakes and shallow seas. But the challenge isn't just warming the planet, it's creating breathable air. Scientists design biofactories of algae and genetically modified plants that can thrive in extreme conditions. These plants not only survive, but also produce oxygen on a large scale, preparing the planet to receive millions of new inhabitants. However, terraforming is not a quick process. It takes centuries for a planet to reach a natural balance. In the meantime, the first generations of settlers live in pressurized megadomes, watching through their windows as a once barren world slowly comes to life. And as Mars transforms, new frontiers open up. Because humanity isn't satisfied with just one planet. The next step, exploring beyond our solar system. To reach other worlds, it wasn't enough to simply want to. We had to completely reinvent the concept of space travel. Old chemical fuel rockets became obsolete, replaced by technologies capable of reducing journeys that once took years to just months or even weeks. The breakthrough came with nuclear fusion propulsion, using the same energy as the stars to accelerate massive cargo ships and passenger vessels. Imagine boarding a ship kilometers long, with entire neighborhoods built inside. While the ship slices through space at unimaginable speeds, families live as usual, working, studying, growing food, and even getting married, all among the stars. But the real game changer was the advent of experimental interstellar ships. Using space warp fields, these vessels bend the fabric of space-time itself, shrinking almost infinite distances. Suddenly, traveling to exoplanets located dozens of light years away was no longer a distant dream, but the next logical step in human exploration. And each of these ships is not just transportation, it's a self-sustaining ecosystem designed to function for decades without external resources. An innovation that not only took us farther, but also taught us to live independently, essential when your nearest neighbor might be billions of kilometers away. But for the entire journey to be worthwhile, life in space needed to be not just possible, but comfortable. Living in a colony outside Earth isn't just about survival, it's about creating a home in a place where, theoretically, life shouldn't exist. The first generations of settlers learned this quickly. Inside massive domes or pressurized modules, architecture blends functionality and beauty. Vertical gardens purify the air. Artificial rivers add humidity, and transparent panels simulate a permanently blue sky. Daily life is a mix of earthly routines and innovations only space can offer. Children study in classrooms where gravity can be adjusted for experiments. Restaurants serve dishes made with ingredients grown in hydroponic farms, while holograms broadcast concerts, lectures, and events in real time from anywhere in the solar system. Work has also changed. Most jobs are related to colony maintenance, scientific research, or technological development. Engineers, biologists, and space pilots are as common as teachers and artists. And of course, there's tourism. Visitors from Earth pay fortunes to spend days on Mars, floating in reduced gravity, or exploring alien landscapes. But despite all the technology, the longing for Earth remains. That's why entire areas of colonies are designed to recreate forests, beaches, and mountains. A reminder of where we came from, and a motivation to never forget what it means to have a planet to call home. And even with all this comfort, the human spirit of adventure remains alive. After all, there are far more distant worlds waiting to be discovered. In the beginning, traveling to space was a privilege reserved for astronauts and billionaires. Today, it's a global market worth trillions. Specialized companies offer packages ranging from a simple stay in Earth's orbit to complete adventures in Martian colonies or luxurious orbital stations. Imagine spending your vacation floating in a hotel with a panoramic view of Saturn's rings, or walking on the surface of Mars in a custom suit that regulates temperature, oxygen, and even plays birdsong to ease the loneliness of Martian silence. There are also more extreme tours, such as exploring ice caves on distant moons or joining scientific expeditions to exoplanets still undergoing terraforming. Space tourism, however, is not just leisure. It drives new technologies, creates jobs, and brings interplanetary cultures closer together. It's common to see events that gather people from Earth, Mars, and even the first lunar colonies, exchanging experiences as if they were international tourists, except here, international means between worlds. And for the boldest travelers, there's exploratory tourism, journeys on pioneering ships to visit places where few humans have set foot. There are no tour guides or luxury hotels, just the vastness of the unknown, where every step could be a milestone in history. But along with opportunities, there are also risks. Living and traveling beyond Earth means facing dangers far beyond anything we've ever known. As amazing as living and traveling through the cosmos is, life beyond Earth is far from perfect. Every planet, every moon, every space station carries unique risks, some predictable, others impossible to foresee. Cosmic radiation is one of the greatest threats. Outside Earth's magnetic field, settlers must live under thick layers of shielding or underground to avoid health damage. Even short trips require advanced protective suits and systems. Another challenge is gravity. Spending long periods in low gravity environments affects muscles, bones, and even the circulatory system. While technologies like artificial centrifugation and genetic therapies help, the human body still needs to adapt to each new world. There's also the psychological factor: extreme isolation, distance from Earth, and the constant awareness of living in an artificial environment can cause anxiety and depression. That's why colonies invest in green spaces, community activities, and immersive technology to maintain mental health. And of course, space is unforgiving. A life support system failure, a meteorite impact, or a solar storm can turn an ordinary day into a desperate fight for survival. This fragility, paradoxically, is what makes us stronger and more united. Space colonization is the greatest leap in human history, an achievement that redefines who we are and where we're going. And in the end, the question isn't whether we can live on other planets, but how many new homes we will claim.